morning, I want to encourage somebody that in that situation, the Lord is telling you that He is with you. Always, not sometimes, but He says that I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Hallelujah. In your life, you have come to meet people. You've met different kinds of people in your life. You've met people that have helped you. You've met people that you have helped. People you've supported. People you have given money. People you have helped in your life. And when it's time for people to show love towards you, when it's time for people to come to your aid, you look around and there is no one to be seen. There is no one to come to your aid. Sometimes you hide in your room and you cry and you weep from morning to evening and you have nobody to tell your story to. You don't have anybody to listen to you, and you are shambled, you are destroyed, you are weak, and you think that the end of the world has come. Hallelujah. You think that you've reached the end of your years, you've reached the end of your life. You want to give up because you feel alone in that situation. Because you are in a situation, they don't want to even know your problem. They don't want to listen to whatever you are going through. But some years ago, some time ago, they were your friends. They were your friends. They were meeting you. You were meeting them, helping them, supporting them. But it's gotten to a point. It's gotten to a certain time. Yeah. I mean, when you look around and you don't find them. You don't see them anymore. You don't even hear of them. They don't even call you on their phone. All because you are in a certain situation. All because you are going through a particular issue. And at that point in time, sometimes you are tempted to even believe that the Lord has forsaken you. Because you are praying for so many years. You are praying for so many months. You are praying for so many weeks. And there is no answer. No answer is coming. And at that point, you feel that even the Lord has forsaken you. I pray that today the Lord will speak to somebody. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. So you will find yourself, sir. So you find yourself in a situation that you think that people have forsaken you, even your best friend, somebody that you trust so much, somebody that you share your good times with, somebody that you have, I'm confided in, together, and you've confided in the person, you've shared your great times with him or her, you remember this person, but when you got to that situation, all these people have left you because of your situation, and you feel lonely and you feel forsaken in life. Even people that you believed in, people that you thought said, these people at all costs will be with me, they've all forsaken you, they've left you on your own. You look around yourself, you look around the world, you look around, and all that you can see is your ceiling, and all that you can see is your telly, and all that you can see is your clothing and your shoes around, and these things cannot help you in your life. They cannot support you. You feel lonely. You feel that you have been rejected by people because of whatever you are going through. You are facing life by yourself You will fight and fight and go to fight. You are tired. You cannot do anything again. You cannot force again. Nothing. You want to give up. You want to end your life. You want to commit suicide because you feel lonely, because you think that nobody cares. You feel as if God has forsaken you. The other day I was talking to somebody about this issue, and the brother said, look, even your shadow, he made a circumstance or the story we were saying, even your shadow, when you are in darkness, no, your shadow leaves you. When you are in light, the shadow that you have been working with, no, is with you. But when you get to the darkness, the hard times, you know, the shadow will even leave you. So you feel that even your shadow has left you in your life. You feel that people have left you. Life has turned around in your life. Things have gone worse. Things have gone bad. But I've got good news for you, my brother. The Bible says that Jesus told his people, he said, look, let them know that I am with you always, even to the end of the world. Now let's look at something from the book of Matthew, chapter number 26. Verse number 56. Matthew 26. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 26, verse 56. But all this was done. The scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled. Then all the disciples forsook him and fled. My brother who is listening to me, now the Lord Jesus that we are following, at one point realized, felt the same that you are feeling. Whatever we have read today, it tells us that the disciples even forsook him. They ran away and they left him at the point that Jesus needed the people around him most, at the point that Jesus needed the disciples to encourage him. He looked round left, he looked at the right, he looked behind, and the people had left him. He was left on his own. And the people around him, people who he had helped. And I was trying to ask myself a few questions. I said, where was Lazarus when Jesus was lonely? When was Lazarus? Because we know the story of Lazarus. Jesus, the Bible says that Lazarus was Jesus' friend. So at the point that Jesus needed somebody, the Bible says that everybody has forsaken him. Where was Lazarus? Hallelujah. Where was Lazarus? The Bible says that Lazarus was Jesus' friend. And I asked myself again, where is the woman with the issue of blood? We read that this woman, was having issue of blood. And as a result of that, the Lord healed him. So at the point that Jesus needed somebody that he had helped, somebody that he had healed, where were they at that time? Where was the woman with the issue of blood? Where has she gone to? They've all forsaken the Lord. Because at that point, he was on his own. At that point, there was nobody even that Jesus could look up to. Hallelujah. At that point, there was nobody there. Oh, forsaking him. The same way you are going through. The same way people have forsaken you. People you have helped, they've left the sin. And you ask yourself, where is Mami Kukua that I helped? Where is Auntie Comfort that I helped some years ago? You call them and they don't want to know. You call them, they don't want to even pick up the phone. But I'm here to encourage you that the Lord is still in control. The Lord is still in control. He knows you. The Lord is beside you. I ask myself this question again. Where is Jairus and his daughter? The Bible says that Jesus, a widow's son died and Jesus raised him up. Where is that widow? Where is Jairus and the daughter? Where are the miracles that Jesus did? He fed fed people. He fed a lot of people. People came to him for healing. People came to him to be ministered to. I asked myself that, where are all those people? The Bible says that they all forsook him. Even the disciples even forsook him. Hallelujah. Even the disciples forsook him. You are listening to me. It looks as if people have forsaken you. People have left you alone. They've left you to struggle on your own. There is nobody that could come to your aid. You look around and it's all about tears. You look around and nobody is prepared to support you. The Lord saying that I am with you, even to the end of the world. So don't be tired. Don't feel that you are forsaken. Don't think that you are on your own. You have somebody with you. You have the Lord with you. You have the Spirit of God with you. The Lord says that He is with you. You are going through trials. You are going through temptations. You are going through difficult times. And it looks as if you are going to hurt yourself. You want to cry. You want to kill yourself because of that situation. You feel lonely. But the Lord says that I am with you even to the end of the world. Shall we look at something from the book of Deuteronomy? Deuteronomy chapter 31 verse 6, I read, "Be strong and of good courage. Do not fear nor be afraid of them. For the Lord your God, He is the one who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you." Be strong, be strong, be strong. So my brother, my sister listening to me, this morning the Bible says that be strong, encourage yourself, shawhudin, and don't be afraid. Because the Lord will go with you. The Lord will stand by you. It doesn't matter the situation. It doesn't matter how you feel. It doesn't matter how the world has turned around about you. But the Lord says that, He will go with you. The Lord will be with you. He will stand by your side. The Lord will stand with you. It's true that people have left you. It's true that people have forsaken you. It's true that people that you really trusted them, people that you really, invested in them, people that you've helped before, they've all forsaken you. But this morning the Lord says that, look, be strong, encourage yourself, put fear aside, put the tears aside, put your crying aside, and be strong, encourage yourself, and put fear aside. Don't be afraid, because the Lord will go with you, because the Lord will stand with you, because the Lord will protect you. No, He will not leave you or forsake you. The Lord that we serve is not a God who said that I'll go with you, but when it gets to the middle, it gets to the hot point, you will run away. There are people who will say that, oh, look, I'll stand with you, I will go with you. But believe you me, when the fight becomes tough, when the living becomes hard, they will run away and leave you. But the Lord says that He will not forsake you, He will not run away from you, He will stand with you, He will be with you. In tears, He will be with you. In fire, He will be with you. In sorrow, He will be with you. Oh, in the rivers, He will be with you. In waters, He will be with you. This is the God that we serve. Now, when you look at the book of Isaiah, chapter 41, verse number 10, it says that fear not. It continues to encourage us that we should fear not. So my brother, who are you in that situation? My sister, who kona ahamu watitimu nyamese emau mohu adiawo huna mane mohu nemon. Be strong, be strong, and put away fear, because He, the Lord your God, no, He is with you. He will not destroy you. He will not disappoint you. Be not dismayed. Be not be dismayed. made, because the Lord your God is with you. He will strengthen you. The book of Isaiah 41 verse 10. He says that he will strengthen you. Onyami obeshawote. Onyami obeshawun cry. Onyami obeche choyure. Onyami obeche make yourself. But probably see ye. Now you feel empty. Now you feel rejected. Now you feel dejected. But God is telling you this morning that put away fear. Put away the crying. Put away, you know, the thing that have made you become so low, and encourage yourself. Encourage yourself, because you have somebody who will stand with you. You have somebody who will be with you. You have somebody who is prepared to go with you, even through the fires, even through the waters. The Lord will be with you. At one point in time, I was just thinking, there are people that I've helped, there are people that I've fasted for, there are people that I've prayed for, there are people that I've counseled, there are people that I've advised, there are people that I've encouraged, there are people that I've supported financially, but at one point in life, it looks as if people that I've helped have forsaken me. I was left on my own. It was all about tears. I couldn't understand why people that I've helped should leave me. If you call them and they wouldn't even pick up the phone. And the Lord spoke to me, so look, these people have come into your life. They're not supposed to stay in your life. Let them go. Hallelujah. This morning, I'm encouraging you, the people who have come to your life and you expect them to help you because you helped them some time ago, let them go. They've left your life. They've not, the Lord is not purpose for them to stay. It is purpose that they will come and go. Let them live your life. Let them go and depend on God. And let the Lord be your banner. Let the Lord strengthen you. Rely on God. Put your trust in God. Let the people leave you. Let them go, because they cannot help you. They will help you and they will give up on you. But if the Lord comes into the scene, the Lord will bring the difference. The Lord will make the difference. Allow the Holy Spirit, allow the Lord Jesus Christ to support you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Now the story is told about a man who was walking by the seaside. You know, he was walking in the shores, and he noticed that there were four footsteps in the sand. And anytime that he got to a difficult situation, he realized that he could only see two footsteps. So one day he questioned God. He said, God, I know when good things are happening to me, I can see you by my side, because I see the footsteps, two of them to be yours, because you are saying that, you will say that you'll be with me always to the end of the world. But I see you when things are good, I see four footsteps, meaning that you are with me. But when I get to the tough time, I don't see four footsteps, but I see only two footsteps. So I say that, oh God, I am alone in that situation. Why do you do this to me? And the Lord said to him that, look, the footsteps are me and you when we are going, but when you are in the difficult time, you, I'm able to carry you. I carry you on my arms, and you don't see the full footsteps. The two footsteps that you see are my footsteps that you see. So I carry you in my arms, although you are in trouble, although you are going through the situation, although you are sad, I carry you in my arms, and you are not able to walk in the trouble. But I carry you in my arms, so that I will carry you through the problem.
Maybe you are thinking that you are on your own. The story is also told in the book of 2 Kings, chapter number 6, verse 16 and 17. It talks about Elisha. The Bible says that Elisha and Gehazi were in trouble. The enemies had risen up against them, and they were terrified. Gehazi was terrified because the enemies were so strong. He could see the enemies, and he was worried, and he went to Elisha. Elisha, and he said, Elisha, we are in trouble because these our enemies are here to destroy us. Hallelujah. And Elisha, the man of God, knew that the Lord will not forsake them. Elisha, the man of God, knew that the people that, the ammunition that they had were stronger than the ones in the world. So he opened the eyes of Gehazi. And the Bible says that Gehazi saw the mountains and he saw how spiritually God that they served had brought in ammunition, had brought in chariots, had brought in horses, had brought in, things to fight the enemy. So Gehazi realized that the things that were with them, were greater than the things that he saw. Hallelujah. My brother who is listening to me, what you have in your life, what you have around you, the protection you have around you is greater than whatever you are going through. I know that God is more than able to see you through. He says that I am with you even to the end of the world. So don't feel that you are left on your own. Don't think that you have been forsaken by people. Don't think that you have been forsaken by God. But God is with you. The Lord says that he is with you. Even in trials and temptation, even in your hard times, you are not on your own. In your difficult times, you are not on your own. My brother, cheer up, encourage yourself, and put away fear, and put away the struggle, and put away the crying, and put away the wailing, because you have somebody with you. You have somebody who is always with you. He is going to back you. He is going to take you through the storm. He's going to take you through the fire. He's going to take you through your trials and your temptations, because he has said it. Everything that the Lord has said, he says that it comes to pass. What are you going through? What do you think is your problem? What is bothering your mind? Why do you feel rejected? Why do you feel forsaken? God has not forsaken you. If the Lord has not forsaken you, don't feel distracted. Don't feel rejected, because you have somebody who will fight for you. You have somebody who is behind you. You have somebody who will struggle with you in times of need, in times of difficulty, in times of problems. God will show forth. The Lord will show forth. You will see the great hand of God. You will see the mercies of God. You will see the power of God. Don't put your trust in man. Put not your trust in man, but put your trust in God. Put your trust in God, because he's the only one who can see you through. Nyame onkaho, nyame onhwe wo so, nyame onbo ho ban. Da sene nyame ban ne da so tinkoma, ye besan ate ye honka. Eni minyame uchie mi sambre, enu na mi chao. Say in times of difficulty no, hunu in times of hard situations, no, and yes, on Kwana Nam, Nemo Uwa or Namibia or Tawachi, Uwa Namibia or Kamu, Uwa Namibia Betu to Anamonia Sea, and in Yami Shroud, Nami Shouso, not on Bong Hubai. Hallelujah.